guys, welcome to a new video. Today we'll be discussing the HSV color model of image processing. So we already know that there are different types of color models that are used to represent images. So the most commonly used one is the RGB model. I've discussed that in another video. So today I'll be discussing the HSV model. Okay, so the HSV color model, also known as the HSB model, is a color model that is close to how humans perceive color. So in RGB model, what basically happens is that you've got three layers of red film, green film and blue film stacked on top of each another to form your image. So that's the most commonly used model, although humans perceive color in terms of HSV, that is hue, saturation and value. So this color model is the closest that can be used to like sort of simulate how humans can perceive color. All right, so this color model describes the colors, that is your hue, in terms of their shade, that is your saturation, and their brightness value. So basically in the RGB model, we had three values, right? Three different values that represented your intensity of blue, green, and our color of a particular pixel, right? So in this model, we also have three values corresponding to your hue, saturation, and value for your particular pixel, okay? So first of all, how do we get your HSV values from your RGB values? All right. So our input is like we have RGB values of a pixel as a number from 0 to 255. We are considering our standard 8-bit image. Okay. So we have this with ourselves, and you can just iterate this process for all the pixels until you get all the HSV values for all your pixels in your image. Okay. So I'm just doing it for one particular pixel. But you can repeat this process by the n times, where n is the number of pixels of your image, to get the total HSV value for all the pixels of your image. Okay, so let's say we have our RGB values of a pixel. So to convert them from RGB to HSV, firstly we are going to be dividing our RGB values by 255. So doing this brings our values in the range from 0 to 1. Okay, so after doing this, I'm going to be labeling them my new RGB values. Okay. So next up, I'm going to be finding three values, which I've defined as Cmax, Cmin, and difference from my RGB values. So Cmax is basically the maximum of my RGB, Cmin is the minimum of my RGB value, and difference is the difference between your Cmax and Cmin. Okay. So next up, I'll be calculating my hue. So there are, you've got four conditions to calculate your hue. So first up, if your Cmax and Cmin both are zero, then that means that your hue is zero. Okay, if your Cmax is your red color, so say you've got red as your, so after dividing by 255, your value of red is your highest, your maximum, your Cmax. If Cmax is R, then your hue is calculated by this formula, that is G minus B divided by your difference, and you multiply that by 60 and you add 360 to that, and then you find your remainder when dividing this whole value by 360. So this is the modulo operator. If you're not familiar, this gives an output as your remainder. So just a small example, if I say 10 modulo 4, that means after dividing 10 with 4, what is the remainder? So you get 2 as your output. Okay. So similarly, in this case, if your Cmax is R, then using this formula, input the values of G and B that you calculated, divided by your difference, multiply by that by 60, add 360 to that, and take the remainder after dividing by 360. That's your hue value. Okay. So this is if Cmax is R. Now, next up, if Cmax is G, then you have a similar kind of formula that is given here. So apply this if your Cmax is G, and if Cmax is B, you've got a similar kind of formula again. Okay, so you've got three formulas for three different cases if your Cmax is either one of them, and if Cmax and Cmin both are zero, then you obviously have that your hue is zero. Okay, so using this formula, you calculate your hue. Okay, next up, we find our saturation. So if Cmax is zero, then saturation is defined as 0. And if Cmax is not equal to 0, then saturation is given by this formula. That is, you divide your difference of Cmax and Cmin divided by your Cmax, and you multiply that by 100. Okay, so this is your saturation formula. And your value is simply defined as Cmax multiplied by 100. Okay, so just as we saw now, we found Hue, right? So if you see basically, if I recall basics of linear algebra, if you divide any number by 360, it has the following set of possible remainders, right? It can start from 0, 1, 2 and go up to 359, okay? So these are 360 values in total. This set has 360 values in total, since we are indexing our values from 0. So based on the Hue values computed, Hue is divided into 6 parts, each of 60 degrees and each from 0 to 360. So 360 is not included here. This is just to be noted, because since we are starting from 0 to go up to 360 values, we go up to 359. So it's divided into 6 broad ranges. So if your degree value, so that say using those three big formulas that I just showed you a couple of minutes ago, and using that you find your value of Hue, and if it lies between 0 to and 60, that means that the Hue is red. Similarly, if it lies between 61 and 120, it's yellow. If it lies between 121 to 180, it's green. And similarly, you got different ranges of 60 values each for cyan, blue and magenta. Okay, so Hue, after calculating, basically gets sorted into one of these 6 categories. Okay, so that's how you visualize your Hue. And saturation basically just describes the amount of gray present in your particular color. From so it's a value that goes from 0 to 100%, where 0 produces gray and a faded effect. So if your saturation is 0, it means that you have your faded effect and it's not really colorful, it's only grayish. And if your saturation is 1 or 100%, that means your saturation produces your primary color effect. Okay, so no gray absolutely. And your value describes the brightness or intensity of color from 0 to 100%, where 0 is totally black and 100 is full intensity or full brightness. Okay, so that's your value. So just to make a small visualization in your RGB frame and your HSV frame, I've written a small Python script that I'll show you just a moment. I'll show you the Python script that will clearly define, like you can clearly see what you mean by HSV and what you mean by RGB. Okay, so this is the Python script here. I'm not going to be explaining the script. I've just basically captured my video feed from the CV2 using OpenCV and just written a basic for loop to get my frame and converting my frame to RGB and HSV. Then I'm showing my frame and HSV. Okay, so let me run this. So let's run this and hopefully you can see. Okay, awesome. Allowed webcam access to Python. All right, so if you see carefully, my left screen, the screen that you see on your left is my normal RGB screen. And so this is RGB on the left, and what you see on the right is your HSV. So if you can, this is my finger. So based on my RGB screen, that is on this particular pixel, it calculates my HSV Hue value using those formulas that I mentioned. And it sorts that particular value into one of the 6 categories. So since in my HSV frame, it's showing a sort of reddish, I would say, color at my fingertip. That means the Hue value is between 0 to 60, my first 60 values, right? So that's my Hue value. Similarly, for all the entire frame, for each and every pixel, your Hue value is calculated, and using that we can see the HSV frame and RGB frame. Okay, so this frame, although it may not seem like it, is what the human usually perceive. Okay, so this is the color model that is closest and resembles closest to what humans see as color. Okay, so I'll just terminate the program here. So yeah, I hope that was helpful, the Python script. And so Yeah, basically. So that's it for this video. And so if I hope you enjoyed the video as much as I did, and hope you gained your knowledge about HSV color model. Check out my previous video on the RGB color model if you haven't seen it. That will also be pretty helpful. And yeah, I'll see you in the next video, guys. And make sure to like, share, and subscribe if you found it helpful. See you guys. Bye-bye.